Did you know that salt, a common ingredient in our kitchens, was once so valuable it was used as a form of currency? That's right. Salt was worth its weight in gold. Now, we're not suggesting you start trading your salt shaker for a new car, but this little factoid underscores the exceptional importance of salt in our lives. It's not just a flavor enhancer, it's a life sustainer. Now, when we talk about salt, we're not just referring to the white crystals in your salt shaker. There's a whole world of salt out there waiting to be explored. And today, we're going to take a deep dive into that world, focusing on three types of salt: Celtic salt, Himalayan salt, and your everyday table salt. Each possesses unique characteristics, potential health benefits, and even drawbacks. But not all salts are created equal. Let's dive into the world of Celtic, Himalayan, and table salt. First up, we have Celtic salt, also known as gray salt. It's harvested manually from the coastal areas of France. Now, this isn't your ordinary salt harvesting. It involves a centuries-old method where salt farmers, called paludiers, skim the top layer of salt off the surface of the evaporating seawater in clay pools. This labor-intensive method ensures that the salt retains its natural moisture and trace minerals, giving it that distinctive gray color and a bit of a moist texture. Celtic salt is like a mineral treasure chest. It's packed with over 80 trace minerals, including iron, 3 magnesiums, which I'll get into in a moment, and potassium. These minerals not only contribute to its unique taste, but they also play a crucial role in our body. Iron keeps our blood healthy, magnesium helps regulate muscle and nerve function, and potassium balances fluids in our body. But what about health benefits? Celtic salt is known for promoting good digestion. It aids in the absorption and assimilation of nutrients, making it a great addition to your meals. It also helps maintain electrolyte balance, which is essential for many bodily functions. However, like all good things, Celtic salt should be consumed in moderation. Despite its health benefits, it's important to remember that it's still salt, and high intake can lead to increased blood pressure and other health complications. And let's not forget the environmental aspect. The traditional harvesting process of Celtic salt is eco-friendly, making it a sustainable choice. It doesn't require any modern machinery, and it doesn't cause any pollution. Celtic salt, with its unique harvesting process and rich mineral content, certainly sets a high bar. But can Himalayan salt match up? Let's find out. Next, we journey to the foothills of the Himalayas, the source of the beautiful pink Himalayan salt. Just as the name suggests, this intriguing variety of salt originates from the ancient seabeds of the Himalayan mountains. Its formation dates back to over 200,000 years ago. Now that's what you call age to perfection. Himalayan salt is renowned for its mineral content. It's like a mineral cocktail, boasting a staggering 80-plus trace elements. Yes, you heard right, over 80. Now that's really close to Celtic. Among these, the presence of iron imparts that characteristic pinkish hue that makes it stand out in the salt crowd. But the pink Himalayan salt isn't just about good looks. It's also about good health. The rich mineral content contributes to a host of potential health benefits. For instance, the calcium and magnesium help maintain strong bones and muscles. The potassium aids in balancing bodily fluids and promoting cardiovascular health. And the iron, well, it not only makes the salt pink but also helps carry oxygen to our cells. However, like every hero with a cape, our pink perfection has its share of drawbacks too. Despite its mineral richness, the concentrations of these trace elements in pink Himalayan salt are quite low. So, while it's a good supplemental source, it should not be relied upon as the primary source of these minerals. Furthermore, the pink Himalayan salt is a bit more expensive than its counterparts. So, if you're on a budget, this might be a point to consider. But then again, luxury comes at a cost, doesn't it? Himalayan salt, with its myriad of trace minerals and striking pink color, certainly gives Celtic salt a run for its money. But how does common table salt fare? Let's find out in our next segment as we continue our salty escapade. Last, but not least, we have table salt, the salt that most of us are familiar with. This everyday essential is the most common type of salt, found in nearly every kitchen worldwide. So, how is this salt produced, you may ask? Well, it's typically mined from salt deposits left by dried-up bodies of water. After mining, it undergoes a refining process to remove impurities and other trace minerals. What we're left with is almost pure sodium chloride. Now, let's talk about the mineral content of table salt. Unlike its counterparts, Celtic and Himalayan salt, table salt doesn't boast a wide array of minerals. However, it does have one advantage: iodine. You see, back in the day, iodine deficiency was a major health problem. To combat this, table salt was fortified with iodine, and voila, we have iodized salt. This little addition has played a significant role in preventing iodine deficiency disorders like goiter. But it's not all roses with table salt. Alongside the iodine, table salt also often contains anti-caking agents. These chemicals prevent the salt from clumping in humid conditions, keeping it free-flowing. While they do a great job at that, some health enthusiasts express concerns about these additives. The main drawback of table salt, however, lies not in its production or what's added to it, but in its consumption. The high sodium content in table salt can contribute to high blood pressure and other cardiovascular issues when consumed in large quantities. But remember, our bodies do need some sodium to function properly. It's all about balance. And there you have it, table salt, the everyday essential, the common denominator of our kitchens. It may not have the exotic allure of Celtic or Himalayan salt, but it's been a reliable companion in our culinary adventures. It has its benefits, like the addition of iodine, but also its drawbacks, like the high sodium content and the inclusion of anti-caking agents. So, table salt, the staple of our kitchens, has its perks and pitfalls. Now, let's see how these three stack up against each other. Now that we've explored these three types of salt, it's time for the ultimate salt showdown. Let's kick things off with mineral content. Celtic salt, harvested from the coastal regions of France, is a powerhouse of minerals. It boasts an impressive array of 82 trace minerals, including potassium, magnesium, and calcium. It's a balanced mix of these 82 minerals. Here's an intriguing fact about Celtic salt. It has three magnesiums: magnesium chloride, magnesium bromide, and magnesium sulfate, which assist in the absorption of water into our cells. Now, that's what we call a mineral-rich rock star. Himalayan salt, on the other hand, hailing from the pristine mountains of the Himalayas, isn't far behind. With over 80 trace minerals, it's a close contender. This pink wonder comes with bonus points for its added aesthetic appeal, making your kitchen shelf look like a geologist's dream. Now, if we turn our attention to the humble table salt, it's a little less glamorous. It's mostly sodium chloride with a smattering of iodine. While it may not win the mineral content race, it does play a vital role in maintaining thyroid health thanks to that iodine. Moving on to potential health benefits, both Celtic and Himalayan salts bring a lot to the table, pun intended. Their high mineral content can help balance the body's electrolytes, support proper nutrient absorption, and even aid in detoxification. However, keep in mind that these are trace amounts we're talking about, so don't expect a mineral miracle from your salt shaker. Table salt, while often demonized, is not without its merits. It's a reliable source of iodine, which is essential for healthy thyroid function. Plus, it's usually the most affordable option. But what about the drawbacks? Excessive salt intake, regardless of the type, can lead to health issues like high blood pressure and heart disease. So remember, while these salts may have their unique perks, none of them provide a free pass to overindulge. Before I continue, I'd like to issue a little disclaimer. Our findings are derived from published research on the mineral composition and the existence of trace elements within these salts. Please note that this isn't just our personal opinion. I thought it was important to highlight that. We are not in any way promoting any type or brand of salt. The results are based on findings of pure mineral content. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. The rankings. Drumroll, please. Based on our analysis, Celtic salt takes the crown for healthiest salt, with Himalayan salt as the runner-up. Table salt, while still a pantry staple, comes in last due to its lower mineral content. I hope that you've learned something from today's video. Remember, no matter which salt you choose, moderation is key. Well, there you have it. The world of salt is far more complex and diverse than one might think. From the ocean's robust Celtic salt, packed with over 80 trace minerals, to the Himalayan pink salt, mined from ancient seabeds with its own unique mineral profile. And then there's the humble table salt fortified with iodine. Each of these salts has its own tale to tell. We've dived deep into their mineral content, potential health benefits, and even some drawbacks. It's clear that while all salts can play a role in our diets, they're not all created equal. Celtic salt takes the crown for the healthiest, closely followed by Himalayan salt, with table salt bringing up the rear. But remember, regardless of which salt you choose, moderation is key. So the next time you reach for that salt shaker, remember, you're not just adding flavor, you're adding a sprinkle of history, geography, and health to your plate. Until next time, stay wonderful and healthy.